So this is part three of an overview of my Star Wars and toy collection, as asked for by many of you. I'm just going to give you a look in at cabinet number two. I'll just open so the reflection doesn't hit on the camera. So in this cabinet here is primarily all Clone Wars stuff, and hopefully you can begin to see some of the figures that are in there. We're a little out of focus here, so let me just try and change that a little, but you'll see the majority of these figures are generally clone commanders, and these guys are pretty much a whole range of stuff from Commander Fox in the back. We've got Stone, new ARC troopers. Up at the back you've got some plain regular clones, a couple of variations in Captain Rex I think in there. Gree and a few others. Love clones, gotta love all the colours. I'm just a complete sucker for these guys. A cloneaholic. And moving on down to the next shelf is the majority of clones which are not commanders, these are just general clones. You've got a lot of guys in there like Oddball, Matchstick, Gus, Slick, Reese, Jack, a whole host of other guys. Got some regular, just off eBay, just straight clones. Some with no name, I can't remember them all. A couple of, I think it's ATTE tank gunners at the back, and a few variations. One from a clone turbo tank. And the one in the top right corner there is, I think that came from the actual turbo tank squad. So some of them are bought loose. There's one that's never actually came out, as far as I can see, in any set yet. Just straight ahead, it's Droid Bait, who's holding up a visor. Still don't know where this figure's or when it's came out, or if it came out at all, maybe in a battle pack. Somebody let me know if you know, but it was all over eBay for long enough, and plenty of other people like me bought it, but yeah, never know that guy, kind of what he was released in. So this shelf is Clone Commanders again. Probably the majority of these guys are just to kind of show their helmet off, so there's some duplicates from the first shelf. Yes, I am a clone addict, I'm afraid. That's the new ARC Trooper Captain Rex, Cold Weather Gear, Stone and Thire and Cody, a different paint version. That's Goji, Clone Pilot Goji there, which I've replaced the head on, I think it was a matchstick body, a clone matchstick body. So I've kind of tweaked that slightly and given it a backpack from a Halo figure and a Halo gun, just for a bit of variety. And there's a small video on YouTube, a quick short custom and tip, because you'll see a Commander Fox in there who actually has a head, which he doesn't come with, he comes with just a helmet. So that's those guys. Next shelf, you've got a Gaius, the pale blue Senate captain, G-Fawn away at the back, Denal, I think there's another Cody in there. Flamethrower clone trooper, a few other guys from the Wolf Squad, a jetpack custom trooper again, there's a few videos on there. Guys up at the back, I think it's Boyle and Waxer, and a custom Obi-Wan at the back, an ARF trooper, and a few other figures. But yes, as you can tell, I love clones. This is a Mando shelf, a lot of Mandalorian stuff here. There's the Mandalorian Warrior, the brown figure there from the Evolutions pack. Also got Pre Vizsla. That's a Mandalorian Warrior from the 4-pack there with a gun from the ARC Troopers pack. At the back we've got a Jodo Cast, a new version. Bantha Squad guys, an old Boba Fett with the rocket pack. And a young Boba Fett, brand new, from the barely out in the stores wave. A few other Mandalorian Warriors from the bike pack. A Pre Vizsla with his helmet off, a couple of Jangos. And that's pretty much it. So that's a full on Mandalorian kind of shelf. As you can see, my shelves are bursting out, and as I mentioned, I'm in the process of trying to get some new shelves. These guys, as good as these shelves are, when you have as many figures as I do, it's getting a little bit cramped. It's very hard. So this is Sith and Jedi guys, Ki-Adi and Asajj and Dooku, and the brand new really groovy Kit Fisto and Mace with, as I say, as I always say, full on articulation. Yoda and Obi and Ahsoka and Ayla and so forth. And a Grievous, which is actually standing up. He kind of falls down all the time, so nice to see him standing on 2 feet. Moving on down, a figure I love, which no one really seems to have much love for is Hermy Odell, the big, huge, ugly looking dude at the back from Return of the Jedi. From Jabba's Palace, you should say. So there's Robo Nino, groovy little guy from the Bounty Hunter packs. What else have we got there? Nectal Guard, the Orto Platonia, I think it's called, the planet where Obi-Wan and Anakin are with their gear on. Got a couple of vintage collections back there, the Cloud Car Pilot, Lando, Bosk. The Bespin Guard, which I love, but man, that hat is just silly. Fire Speeder Pilot way up at the back, Comic Pack Guy, whose name I cannot remember. And an Ugnaught who's looking for his console, which I've nicked for something else. And what else have we got down here? This is pretty much a droid shelf. And Battle Droid Commandos. A few more there, I'll probably forget the names offhand. I think it's R4 at the front there, R2-D2, Battle Droid Commandos. R5-D4's hiding up the back. A couple of 3PO's, one from the vintage. The brand new R2-D2 vintage collection. We just reviewed that the other day. And all sorts of figures up at the back. Darth Vader's droid. This fire trooper droid. This battle droid with the fire gear. Who doesn't stand up. He just falls over all the time. So hence why he's leaning against the wall. And the final shelf. Something I love. And I have a lot more of these hidden away in cupboards. But is the Kubrick's. Very hard to get a lot of these guys, some fairly rare ones in there, grey, and they're fairly easy to find all the variations in the Boba Fett. But a lot of stuff there, a couple of customs, which is Han and Luke, as Stormtroopers, and other bits and pieces, Darth, and a few others in a Han and Carbonite, and a brand new Saga Legends super articulated Geonosian battle droid. Final shelf is again some more customs. Sorry, not customs, Kubrick's, Jango Fett and Yoda, R5, a couple of Han Solos hiding up the back. A great looking Grievous Kubrick, which if you have a look on eBay you should manage to find. He's very super deformed and kind of strange looking, but I love the figure. Some Mandalorian Warriors. That's Cad Bane's speeder bike with an Anakin. Sorry, an Anakin, what am I on? Or a Singh, I should say. I never liked the Cad Bane that came on that speeder bike, he just didn't seem to be the best, and there's another one on the way in the next couple of months, and that is Cabinet 2. So just get the loop back up. Kubrick's, some more droids, some Clone Wars guys, Jedi's and the Sith, the Mandalorians, lots and lots of clones, clone commanders with no helmets on, lots of other clones, and again all these clone commanders. So there you go, that was cabinet number 2, part 3, even though it was cabinet number 2, and we'll be back with some more videos shortly. If you liked any of these figures, particularly looking for reviews on some of these, or let us know what you thought, best thing to do is join us on Facebook and discuss some of these figures and tell us what you liked and what you didn't, and more videos coming right up.